another experiment of structural analysis 1, that is determination of the deflection of trusses by Willott-Morse diagrams. Okay, so this practical is basically based on the strain energy principle. Okay, so already we have covered the theory portion of the strain energy for the numerical, which is based on portal frame. Okay, so one more variety of numerical may be asked in your examination, that is related to your trusses. Okay, so instead of covering that portion in theory, I have considered this in your practical parts. Okay, so as it is already there in your practical number 5, so therefore by solving this particular numerical, you can easily solve such type of truss numerical in your examination also. Okay, and also in your examination it may be asked for either to solve the portal frame numerical or it for a truss numerical. Okay, so let us see the practical number 5, that is determination of the deflection of truss by Willott-Morse diagram. Okay, so already we have discussed in our theory lecture also that in as per the strain energy principle, the deflection of the node of the truss can be calculated by using a formula that is called TUL upon AE. Okay, where T is the force in any member of a given loading, U is the uniform unit load applied at that particular point for which we have to calculate the deflection is required, L is the length of the member, A is the cross-sectional area, and E is the modulus of elasticity of steel, which may be considered as 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton per mm square. Okay, now here L upon A is considered as a property of a member. Okay, it is related to property, okay, which is equal to the extension per unit load. So it may be also determined for each member separately by suspending a load form from its node from it and notice the extension. Okay, so for this case, a parallel apparatus which is consist of a 4 panel of pratt truss, so this pratt type of truss geometry is available in our lab. Okay, and you can see that, and each panel is consist of a 40 centimeter length in horizontal direction, whereas a 30 centimeter length in vertical direction, and load can be applied on each panel point. Okay, all the tension member are provided with detachable spring so as to obtain the appreciable deformation of the member. Okay, now the direction of the diagonal member may be changed. Okay, and the apparatus can be illustrated visually by the nature of the forces and set up in the various direction. So this is a particular pad type of truss. Okay, so I will show you how it looks like. So let's say this is a lab manual. Okay, so if you go for this is a particular apparatus. Okay, this is a Pratt type of truss geometry. Okay, this is a Pratt truss geometry is there. This is a vertical member. These all are the vertical members. Okay, and these are the horizontal members. Okay, and the load can be suspended from this hanger. Okay, here, and if you apply this load, the tension and compression forces developed in the vertical and horizontal as well as the diagonal member. So what is our aim? To calculate the deflection of this particular truss, okay, by using the manual calculation as well as by using the theoretical calculation, by using the experimental value. Okay, so let us see that. Okay, so this is a particular prototype of, or you can see that this is a free body diagram. Let us start marking from here, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Okay, so as we know that this is 30 centimeter, this is 40 centimeter length. Okay, now U0, U1, U2, U3 and U4 are the diagonal members. Okay, now L0, L1, L2, L3 and L4 are the respective length. Okay, from the of each span. Okay, now observed value u0 l1. Let us see where is u0 l1. This is u0 l1 is there, u0 l1, u1 l2, then u2 l2, okay, then this u4, this is u4, l2 is there like this, okay, and u2 l3. Next is u2 l3. Where is u2 l3? This is u2 and this is l3, u2 l3, okay. So we can suspend the load, okay, in this L1, L2 and L3. So let us consider U0, L1. So if you apply the load here, let us say 0.6 kg, this is 1.5 kg, 2 kg, 2.6. So if you see the pattern of load, you can gradually increase the load, okay, 0.6, 1.5, 2, 2.6, okay. And for each load, you can directly place the dial gauges and you can directly count the deflection. This is an experimental setup or the experimental performance, okay. Now based on that, let us see how the theoretical value can be calculated. So first of all, we have to calculate the value of theta. So as we know that the geometry is given, this is 30 and this is 40, so we can easily calculate the angle. So angle is equal to 10 theta. If you apply, you will get the value of theta is 36.86. now these are the sides tension of the force in B, J, BC, DC, DF, CG and CI. These are the tensile load we are applied, okay, 2.5 kg, 2 kg, 2 kg, 2.5, 1.25, 1.25, and these are the unit loads, okay. So this is the particular formula by which you can easily calculate the deflection theoretically. So delta is equal to T, okay, T0 into L divided by AE. So 11.5 is the tension applied. This is the summation of tension, that is 11.5, if you see that. And if you sum this all forces, this is 11.5 and this is unit load, okay. O is the unit load, okay, into length of the member, 3.85 average length you can take, okay, divided by AE, area of cross section you have to consider, and length we have to consider, okay. So delta is equal to 294.87 mm. So by analytically you can get the value of delta is equal to 294.87. this is a analytical means theoretical value by using this formula, okay. And practically you can directly place the extensiometer, or you can say that the dial gauges here, and you can directly get the deflection here, okay. Now for sample calculation, how the forces may be developed in this particular section, that is T of BJ, BC, DC. This is like this. This is B, J, then this is B, J, then B, C, then C, I, C, J, this all members, okay. So we have this taken as a forces tension in, or you can say that the forces in B, J, B, C, D, C, D, F, C, G and C, I. These all forces can be calculated as per this particular free body diagram, okay, by using the methods, okay, which is most commonly used to analyze the truss, okay. So you know that these two methods very well as per your engineering mechanics knowledge. So there are two methods. First is method of joint, second is method of section. The most commonly used method is method of joint, so we can go for method of joint. So this, you can draw the free body diagram for calculating the T of BJ, okay. This is TBC is there, this is 1.5 distance is there, okay. Now this is the first diagram, this is the intermediate diagram of the diagonal member, and this is a two-way diagram where the two diagonal meets, okay. So you can directly separate the diagonal member, okay, and can construct a free body diagram like this. And you can, by applying the simple equilibrium condition of summation of fx and summation of fy, you can directly get the value of this forces, that is T of BJ, T of BC here, then here T of DF and T of DC, okay. Once you will get all the forces, this all forces, you can sum this value and you can get the final tensile forces like this, okay. So like way you can easily calculate the forces in all member, okay, and then accordingly you can calculate the unit load and you can get the final answer, okay. So this is the theoretical, and this is also a table which is given in your experimental setup, that is a deflection by calculation, initial load, is 0, then L2 is 0, L3 is 0, then initial dial gauge reading 64, 64, 64, then additional load we can apply 1.5, 1.5 on all cases, in all three hangar we can put the load as 1.5, 1.5, 1.5, then final, this is the gauge reading 422, 412, 817 and deflection, final deflection, this minus this, that is 3.58, 3.48 and 8.15, like this, okay. So this is the final practical reading. Delta 1 is equal to 3.58, delta 2 is equal to 3.48 and delta 3 is equal to 8.15. So delta is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3. So finally delta is equal to 15.21. So this is a typical example, okay, of a portal frame by which you can easily calculate the deflection. So in strain energy method, you will also having a numerical based on a trusses. So generally in trusses you can come across the numerical which is having the unknown, you can find calculation of the deflection, calculation of the members forces, okay, because of the deflection, okay. So all these numericals comes under the category of the strain energy, okay. So this formula, these two formula you can, okay, remember by heart, TUL upon AE. This the formula is applicable to calculate the deflection of the each nodes, okay. And next formula is this delta value. This by using this TUL upon AE formula, this delta value, you can easily calculate the theoretical deflection, and as per the practical, you can easily calculate the value of practical deflection, and then you can compare these two deflection, okay, simultaneously, and you will get the final output, okay. So basically in this type of, whenever you will come across such type of numerical, so you must remember, or you must know the calculation of method of joints, so that you can easily solve the various types of trusses, okay, and you can directly apply the values, or you can directly calculate the value of deflections, okay. So this is all about the experiment number 5, and these all are the readings, okay. So kindly go through this reading, okay, and write down in your SA1 manual under experiment number 4, I think, okay. Already we have considered this experiment as experiment number 5, because already in experiment number 3 we have considered last time as a theory of experiment number 10, therefore we are called it as a experiment number 5, but although as per the sequence order it is a experiment number 4, okay. So kindly go through this detailed calculation, and after understanding, or you can easily understand this, and you can write this in your lab manual, okay. So thank you very much for your kind attentions. Thank you, okay. So one more thing, kindly write this experiment number 5 as well as experiment number 4 by referring this PDF, okay, in your lab manual, and submit this experiment number 4 and 5 under the Google Classroom where the folders were created, okay. So once again, thank you very much for your kind attentions. Thank you.